Dear learner, I welcome you on behalf of School of Engineering and Technology. Myself, Dr. Sanjay Agarwal, I am an Associate Professor in Electrical Engineering from School of Engineering and Technology. Today I am going to discuss topic single phase AC circuits. So on the previous lecture, we have discussed about the DC circuit. In that, we have discussed about the Kirchhoff's current law, Kirchhoff's voltage law, and we have also discussed and different network theorem like superposition theorem, Thevenin theorem, Norton theorem, and maximum power transfer theorem, and how you can convert star connection into delta connection and delta connection into star connection. So today that we are going to start new topic, that is a AC circuit. So AC means what? Alternating current. And here we are focusing on simple single phase. Single phase means what? That means which have two wire, that is a phase and neutral. So we are going to discuss single phase AC circuit. So in this particular topic, we are going to discuss like what is an alternating voltage and current, and how it is differed from direct current. And like then we have to discuss what is a frequency, time period, cycle, alternation, and then we will also discuss about the what is the instantaneous value, peak value, average value and root mean square value of an alternating current. Because whenever we discuss about the DC, so as you know, in DC what happens, the magnitude of current or voltage is always constant with respect to the time. But in case of AC, what happens, it change. That means magnitude of the voltage change with respect to the time. Like suppose we are talking about the single phase AC supply, and we are talking that this single AC supply is working on 50 hertz frequency. So what will happen at like omega t equal to 0, the magnitude of voltage is 0, and if omega t is equal to 90, or you can say pi by 2, so magnitude of voltage is a maximum, that is called peak value. So there are different terminology are used in case of the AC circuit. So we have to understand what are those terminology, like instantaneous value, peak value. Peak value means what? It is a maximum value. Because in the, and then we have to discuss the average value. Average value means what? Because in case of AC, what happens, there is a positive cycle and negative cycle. So there will be some average of the positive cycle and negative cycle. So if you are calculating the net average in one cycle, so it comes zero. So how to this find the average value and root mean square value of the any voltage or current, we have to discuss, and we have to understand how we can calculate the root mean square value and average value, whether it is a sinusoidal waveform, or it is a square wave, or it is a sawtooth wave. So there is some process by which, or you can say methodology by which, you can calculate all these value, like peak value, average value and root mean square value. So as in discussed in the DC circuit, the flow of current in circuit was steady, that means it is a constant, or you can say it is only in one direction. So this is called direct current. The use of DC is limited to very few applications, like it is used for the electroplating, it is used for the charging of the batteries. As you know, battery work on the DC only. So whatever the output that you get from the battery, it is a direct current. And this DC is also used in the electric traction, electronic circuit. Whatever the circuit that you use in, like you can understand the mobile, that is electronic circuit. So the supply that given to that particular circuit is given from the battery, and the output of that battery is DC. So for large scale power generation, transmission and distribution and utilization, an AC system is adopted. So there are some advantages of AC over DC. Like in case of AC, what happens, like suppose you are generating voltage at 11 kV. Right, and there is a 110 megawatt power is there. That means you have to transmit this power from generating station to the consumer side. So what you have to do, you have to convert this this AC power, that means is AC voltage, to high voltage. That means 11 kV has to be converted, either 440 kV or 765 kV. Then you have to transmit this power. So there are some reason why do you step up the voltage. So it is used basically for the economical purpose. That means if you are stepping up the voltage, that means because power is constant, if you are stepping up the voltage, that means current is going to down. If current is going to down, that means there is some losses. I am not talking about the this losses due to the capacitance effect or inductance effect, just I am focusing on whatever the losses is occurring due to the resistance of the wire. That means if you are able to reduce the current, that means you are able to reduce the losses, that is I square R losses. So this is the beauty of the AC. That means you can step up the voltage, you can step down the voltage, but in case of DC it is very difficult to step up or step down. It is possible in case of DC also, there is some device that is used to step up the voltage, that is a chopper. So chopper is a device which is used to step up and step down the voltage, but chopper doesn't have a capability to increase very low voltage to very high voltage. That's why AC is generally used for the generation, transmission and distribution. In AC system, voltage acting in the circuit changes polarity, as you know, because whenever you see the diagrams in the circle, the polarity is on plus minus. That means in positive cycle, it is a plus to minus. Then cycle change, that means polarity of that voltage change negative to positive. And hence, when AC supply, you see the waveform of the AC supply, so it change with respect to time, that is omega t. So in the positive half cycle, you can say the magnitude of the voltage is positive, but in the negative half cycle, the magnitude of voltage is change. That means direction of current is also changing. So now again we have to understand what are the advantage of the AC system over DC system. An alternating voltage can be stepped up and stepped down efficiently by means of transformer, as I already told you, and in one lecture I also discussed about the transformer also. To transmit huge power over a long distance, the voltage are stepped up to 400 kV or 765 kV for the economical reason at the generating station, whereas they are stepped down to very low voltage like 400 or 230 voltage. That means whenever you get AC power at your home, that voltage, as you know, it is a 230 voltage because it is being transferred from generating station. That means it is 11 kV to 765 kV. That means that high voltage you cannot use at your home. That means you needed 230 voltage. That means what you have to do at the receiving side, that voltage need to step down. And how you can step down this voltage? With the help of the transformer. The AC motor, like induction motor or you can say synchronous motor, are very cheap in cost, and it is construction wise it is very simple, and it is more efficient and robust as compared to the DC motor. Now, because if you are using the AC supply, that means you need to some switch gear. Like switch gear means what? Switches, circuit breaker. So switch gear for the AC system is simpler than the DC system. And you know that AC system is universally adopted for the generation, transmission, distribution, at the same time for the utilization of the electrical energy. Here you can see what is the alternating voltage and current. So we are starting from the very basic of the AC. That means first of all we have to understand what is alternating voltage and current. Why it is called alternating? Because the polarity of the voltage is changing in positive cycle and negative cycle. That means it is alternating. That's why it is called alternating. So voltage that changes its polarity and magnitude at regular interval of time is called an alternating voltage. Here you can see this is a supply voltage E. In the positive cycle, how current will flow? Current will flow from A to B. So this voltage is denoted in this cycle, this one, positive cycle, from 0 to 2 pi, when polarity is minus to plus. But in negative half, what will happen? The polarity of this voltage will be changed. Here you can see now this is a negative and this is a positive. Here you can see now direction of the current is reversed. Now how current is flowing? Current is flowing from B to A. If direction of the current is changed, so you can you can see this voltage when current is flowing in this particular circuit. So in positive half cycle, the voltage has been shown from 0 to 2 pi, and negative side, a voltage has been shown from pi to 2 pi with respect to time. So this is a positive voltage, this is a, you can say, this is the amplitude of the voltage, or you can say maximum voltage that you get at pi at t equal to omega t is equal to pi by 2, and this is a negative side. So because it is alternating, that means polarity changing, that's why it is called alternating voltage and alternating current. So because if it is resistance are connected as a load, so in case of resistance, the voltage and current are in same phase, so waveform of the voltage and current will be the same. The magnitude of the current may be changed, because magnitude of the current will depend on the load. How? Because I is equal to what? Applied voltage divided by the resistance. So if resistance is more, that means load is more, that means magnitude of current is less, but direction of the voltage and current will be the same. So an alternating quantity is that quantity which changes periodically both in magnitude and direction with respect to time. Such changes in magnitude and direction is measured in terms of the cycle. Here you can see in this is a one cycle from 0 to 2 pi, that's what is called cycle. So each cycle of AC fundamental consists of two half cycles, namely positive cycle and negative cycle. It is also called waveform or wave shape. While you plotting a graph, usually instantaneous value of alternating quantities are taken along y-axis and time along x-axis. Here you can see this one. So time is drawn on the horizontal axis, and magnitude of the voltage and current are shown on the y-axis. Here you can see the different wave shape of the alternating supply. So our focus is on this one. Here this is called sinusoidal waveform. Here it is called irregular waveform of the supply. Here this one is a triangular wave, this is a square wave, this is a periodic wave, this is a sawtooth wave. So here you can see this is also one cycle from 0 to 2 pi. This is also a one cycle, and this you can say from 0 to maximum, then maximum to 0, maximum to 0 to negative maximum, then 2 pi. So these all are the different shapes of the waveform. It may be for the voltage, it may be for the current. So basically, whatever the supply that you get your home, or it is used for the utilization purpose, that is a sinusoidal waveform. So now, because we are talking about this sinusoidal waveform, so there are different terminology associated for this. So we have to understand these all terms. That is very simple. One is, first is a time period. Time period means what? The time taken by an alternating quantity to complete its one cycle is known time period. That means time taken from 0 to maximum, maximum to 0, 0 to negative maximum, negative maximum to again 0. So this is one cycle. So time taken to complete this one cycle is called time period. So here you can see this 0 to 2 pi. So whatever the time is taken to complete this cycle, it can be shown by this capital T. The another term that you have to understand, that is a frequency. It is very simple term, and as you know that frequency of the AC supply in India is 50 hertz. That means that's and similarly the frequency of the AC supply in USA, it is 60 hertz. So there are some reason why, what are the effect of 50 hertz and 60 hertz, we will discuss in the lectures, what is the effect of this frequency. Now first we have to understand what is a frequency. The number of cycles completed by an alternating quantity per second is known as its frequency. So how you can write frequency? Frequency is nothing but it is a reciprocal of time period, right? So if you have a value of the time period, then you can easily calculate the frequency. So f is equal to 1 by t, and the unit of frequency is hertz. And similarly, the unit of time period is what? It is second. Then amplitude. Amplitude is what? The maximum value attained by an alternating quantity during positive or negative half cycle is called amplitude. So here you can see the amplitude. That means maximum value. Maximum value is where this one is a maximum value. This is also some value, but where you get the maximum value? At pi by 2. So this is called the amplitude, or you can say maximum value of the voltage. If graph is drawn for the voltage, like suppose this curve is showing for the voltage, that means voltage with respect to time. So it will be called the maximum voltage, or generally it is written as E suffix Vm. If this graph is for the current, then it is written as I suffix M. So maximum value of the voltage or current is said as amplitude. It is on the positive side also, it may be from the negative side. So this is also amplitude. Next is instantaneous value. The instantaneous is name is indicating, that meant at particular instant, whatever the quantity you are measuring, that is called instantaneous value. Like the value of an alternating quantity at a particular instant is called its instantaneous value. Like suppose someone is asking, what is the value of voltage at time t equal to 0? So what is the value of this voltage? It is 0. That means instantaneous value at t equal to 0, value of this voltage or current is 0. Like suppose it is asked, what is the instantaneous value of voltage at t equal to pi by 2? So what is instantaneous value? It is an amplitude, or you can say it is a maximum value of voltage and current at pi by 2. Similarly, suppose it is asked, what is instantaneous value at pi by 4? So where will be pi by 4? In between this and this. Suppose like this, this is a pi by 4. So what will be the instantaneous value of this voltage and current? Just draw the graph. That means at this particular point, this will be the voltage, instantaneous value of voltage and current. So I think it is clear what is the instantaneous value and what is the instantaneous current. So at t equal to 2 pi, what is the instantaneous value? It is 0. At 3 pi by 2, what is the instantaneous value? It is a maximum value, or you can say it is a amplitude of that voltage or current. Now another very simple term, that is a cycle. What is a cycle? So cycle is what? If you are drawing like this, this is called cycle. That means in the time t, whatever the graph that you are getting, that is a cycle. So when an alternating quantity goes through a complete set of positive and negative value, or goes through a 360 degree electrical, not mechanical, 360 degree electrical, or you can say 2 pi radian, it is said to have, it is completed one cycle. So this is a one cycle, right? Then next term is called alternation. What is alternation? One half cycle is called alternation. So this is a one alternation, this one. Suppose you are drawing like this one. So this is called alternation. This is also a one alternation. Then there are some relation, like I have already discussed that what is the relation between frequency and time period. The relation between frequency and time is what? Frequency. F is equal to 1 by t. That means reciprocal of time is called frequency. How do you say that t is equal to 1 by f? You can simply understand by this one. Consider an alternating quantity having a frequency of f cycle per second. That means time in 1 second you are completing a frequency, that is a f cycle. So time taken to complete f cycle is equal to what? 1 second. So time taken to complete one cycle is equal to what? 1 by f. It is very simple. So time taken to complete one cycle is what? Basically it is a time period. So this can be said time period t is equal to what? 1 by f. So time taken to complete one cycle is called time period, and it is can be written as 1 by f, or you can say 1 upon frequency, or you can say reciprocal of frequency. Second relation is what? Relation between the frequency and angular velocity. So consider an alternating quantity having a frequency of f cycle per second. Here you can see that angular distance covered in one cycle can be written as 2 pi radian, right? So angular distance covered in one cycle is equal to what? 2 pi radian. So angular distance covered per second in f cycle is equal to what? It can be written as 2 pi radian. So angular distance is what? Angular distance covered per second in f cycle. So if it is written angular distance covered in one cycle by omega, so omega can be written as 2 pi f radian per second. So on the horizontal axis, time is denoted as omega t. So what is that omega? Omega is nothing but it is 2 pi f radian per second. Now basically some voltage waveform or current waveform equations are given, and by that equation you have to determine the different terminology, like we have discussed what is amplitude. Amplitude means you have to find the value of the maximum voltage, value of the maximum current, what is the frequency, what is the time period. So you can say any equations are given, just you compare by the some standard equation. And what are those standard equation for the alternating voltage? Or standard equation for the alternating voltage can be written as that this E small E is what? This small E is instantaneous value. So this E can be written as Em sin theta, where this Em is what? Em is nothing but it is a maximum value of voltage at any particular time. So in case of sinusoidal waveform, Em, when will be Em maximum value? That means theta is equal to or you can say omega t is equal to pi by 2, right? So the standard equation for any sinusoidal waveform for the voltage can be written as E equal to Em sin theta. This sin theta can also be written as Em sin omega t. If equation are in this way, that means omega t like written, then you can compare by this equation. In another word, this omega can also be written as 2 pi f. So this equation may be E equal to Em sin 2 pi f t, because as you know, omega is equal to 2 pi f. Again, if you want to write equation in another form, that means this f can be written as 1 by capital T. That means in form of the time period. So this equation, that means voltage, instantaneous voltage small e, can be written as capital Em sin 2 pi t upon capital T. This small t is changing the is showing the variation. That means suppose if you want to calculate at what is the instantaneous value of the voltage at t equal to 5 seconds, if so what you will do, just you put the value t equal to 5 second here. If you have all the value of Em capital T, that means simply you can calculate, that means what is the value of this sinusoidal voltage at t equal to 5 second. So it will be somewhat, it will be less than maximum value, or it may be the negative. So it depends. But in case of DC, what happens? What about the time t? Time at t equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 5 seconds. The magnitude of the voltage, or you can say the magnitude max, always value is maximum, or you can say it is a constant. But in case of AC, what happens? Because it is changing like this, from 0 to maximum, then maximum, so 0, 0 to negative maximum, like that you, it is changing. So which form of the above equation is to be applied will depend upon the data given. We will understand how do you use this equation with help of one example after the completion of this particular topic. So to determine the various value, for example maximum value, frequency, time period, angular velocity, etc., the given equation is compared with the standard equation of any of the form given above. For instance, maximum value of the voltage Em is equal to what? Coefficient of the sine of the time angle. And frequencies can be written as f is equal to coefficient of the time in the angle divided by 2 pi. So this can be well understood with help of one example. Now what is the value of alternating voltage and current? Because in case of DC, what is what happens? It is always fixed, that is no value is changing. So the voltage and current in DC system are constant, so that there is no problem of the specifying their magnitude. Whereas in AC system, what happens? The alternating voltage and current vary from time to time, as I already explained you. Hence, it is necessary to explain the ways to express the magnitude of alternating voltage and current. Like what is the value of voltage at any particular time? It will be the maximum value. and the quantity is changing, what is the average value, what is the RMS value, that we have to find out. So the following three ways are adopted to express the magnitude of this quantity. And what are these three ways? These three ways are the peak value. Peak value is what? Peak value is nothing but it is a maximum value, or you can say this is an amplitude, or you can say this is a, if you are talking about the voltage waveform, so peak value is written as E suffix M. If it is written for the current, so it is written as I suffix M. So this is a peak value, or you can say amplitude of any quantity. That quantity, it may be the voltage or it may be the current. Second is what? Average value or mean value. That means you have to find out what is the average value of the voltage or average value of current. We will discuss here. And third term is the effective value or RMS value. Because magnitude of the voltage and current is changing with respect to the time, so you cannot say what is the exact value of that voltage. So suppose in our house, whatever the value of the voltage, like we say that at our home, the voltage that is a 230 volt. So that 230 voltage is the average value or mean value or effective value or RMS value. So this value is basically, just you have to remember, that is a RMS value, root mean square value, and root mean square value is also called effective value. So we say, if we are saying we are getting 230 voltage, so it is a RMS value, right? Or if you are saying that you are getting a 5 ampere current and any particular in any appliances, so that 5 ampere current is not a maximum current, it is a RMS current, root mean square current. So in the detail we can again discuss what is the peak value. Here you can see in the figure 3, you can see this one is, so this amplitude is nothing but it is a peak value, right? So maximum value attained by an alternating quantity during one cycle is called peak value. So in one cycle there will be two instant where you will get the maximum value. One is at pi by 2 and another is at 3 pi by 2. So this is also a maximum value, or you can see peak value, but polarity of that peak value will be negative, but amplitude will be the same, magnitude will be the same, but the direction may be the change. Now we have to understand another average value. So generally it is said, what is average? What do you do? Suppose five quantities are given and you have to find out the average. So what do you do? All the five quantities are added and divided by the number of quantities. Like suppose in any class, suppose five students are there and all students get some mark, like someone get in mathematics 30, another get 40, then 55, 60, 70. So what is the average marks of the class of the student? What do? Just you add all the marks and divide by the number of the student, then you get the average value. Similarly, average value in for any sinusoidal wave, from what do? Just you take the instant value at any particular time and you add all this value and divide by the particular instant, then you can get the average value. So the arithmetic average of all the instantaneous values considered an alternating quantity over one cycle is called average value. In case of symmetrical wave such as sinusoidal current or voltage wave, the positive half cycle is exactly equal to the negative half. You have already seen the waveform of the sinusoidal waveform. Here you can see this is a sinusoidal waveform, this one. So this is a positive side, this one is a negative one. So this one is exactly same as this one, but what is the difference? Polarity is different. So here you can say the average of value over a complete cycle is zero. Why? Because this one, suppose 7 average value. So this is also 7. So this is a minus, this is a plus. So if you take plus 7 minus 7, it comes zero. Since work is being done by the current in both the positive and negative half cycle, average value is determined by the regardless of the signs. Hence, to determine average value of alternating quantities having symmetrical wave, only positive half cycle is considered. If wave same is same, that means pattern of the positive side and negative side is same, and if you want to calculate the average value, that means just you consider only the positive side, and you have to take, that means in the positive 0 to pi. So just you take the particular instant from 0 to 2 pi and you add all these value and divide by the number of instant, then you will get the average value of that particular quantity. Here you can see, understand, like this is a sinusoidal waveform for the current. So what if you want to calculate the average value, because this is symmetrical waveform, that means this half, positive half side is exactly equal to the negative side. If you are taking the average value from 0 to 2 pi, so it will be the 0. That means now you have to find the average values, just you consider from 0 to pi only. So just divide from this period 0 to 2 pi in n parts. So like 1, 2, 3 up to n. So like at particular instant 1, the instantaneous value is i1. At instant 2, instantaneous value is i2, i3 and up to in. So if you want to calculate the instantaneous value for this sinusoidal waveform, or you can say for one alternation, just you add i1 plus i2 plus i3 up to in and divide by n. So this i1 plus i2 plus i3 up to in divide by n. So this is what basically, if you are calculating 1 into i1, this is a area of this particular area, small area. So you are adding, if you are just dividing in small strips, and if you are adding this, so this is what, that means this is addition also, this is what, this is basically area. So this can also be calculated, suppose if you are able to say this is the area of this strip, so just you integrate from 0 to pi. So with help of the integration, you can also find the area of this half cycle and divide by the base value, then you can find the average value. You can understand here, now you have to find out the average value of sinusoidal current. So what you have to do, as you know, the equation of this sinusoidal current can be written as I is equal to Im sin theta. This Im is what? This Im is nothing but it is this one, amplitude, or you can say maximum value. And this theta is what? Theta is nothing but it is a omega t, that means a variation, that means it is showing the behavior of the waveform, how the current, or you can say value, magnitude of the voltage is changing with respect to time, right? So as I already told you that if you have to find the average value of any particular waveform, it may be the sinusoidal, it may be the square, it may be the sawtooth waveform, so just you have to find out the area of that particular waveform. If it is symmetrical, that means just you consider only half side, one cycle, half positive cycle, and divide by the base. So area of this half cycle can be calculated with help of the integration. Let this one, this is a area and this is a current I, and this one is a theta. So if you are assuming that this is like a rectangular waveform, so what is the area of this particular, this shaded portion? I into d theta. So this is a I d theta, and you integrate from 0 to 2 pi, so this will give the total area, this one, this one, this total, if you are able to set this one area, so this will be the area of positive half cycle. So this I d theta can be integrated from 0 to pi. So 0 to pi, and this small I, that is the instantaneous value, can be written as Im sin theta d theta. So you integrate, what is the integration of sin theta? Integration of sin theta is minus cos theta. So just you need some mathematics is required here. So if you are integrating sin theta, so it can be written as minus cos theta, just you applied the limit, and what is the limit? 0 to pi. So just put the value here. So this is cos 90 minus cos 0, value of cos 180. Value of cos 180 is what? Minus 1, cos 0 is again 1. So this minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2, and minus 2 multiplied by minus 1, it is a 2. So it is coming 2 Im. So area of positive half cycle is coming 2 Im. And because you are calculating the average value, and that instant is your base is what? 0 to pi, that means pi minus 0. Pi minus 0 is nothing but it is a pi. So you have to calculate the average value. So average value can be calculated by this formula, area of alternation, that means one positive side, and it is coming 2 im, and base is what? Pi. So 2 im upon pi, so it can be written as im upon pi by 2. So after the solving, just put the value pi is equal to 3.14 and you divide this value, so it comes 0.637 im. So you can say that average value of either voltage or current for the sinusoidal waveform, it is a 0.637 times multiplied by the maximum value of the current. If you want to say what is the average value of the voltage, so it will be the 0.637 times multiplied by the maximum value of voltage. Now you have to find out the RMS value of effective value of alternating current. How you can calculate the RMS value? Here you can see the waveform here. So what you have to do, just in the first interval, you calculate the heat. Heat will be what? I1 square R, because this time is divided by the this, I'm just dividing in the N strips. So this total time T is divided by the N. So this particular time can be written as T by N. So first interval, it can be written as I1 square RT by N. In second interval, can be written as I2 square RT by N. Similarly, you can write. So total heat produced can be written as, because RT is common in all the terms, so it can be written as RT I1 square plus I2 square plus I3 square upon IN square upon N. Now you assume, since I effective is considered as the effective value of this current, so again you can find out the what will be the heat developed due to this effective value. This effective value is nothing but it is a DC current. So it can be written as I effective square RT is equal to what? RT multiplied by this quantity. So this RT is common from the left hand side and right hand side, so it will be cancelled out. So this I effective can be written as under root I1 square plus I2 square plus I3 square up to IN upon N. Or you can say this I effective is nothing but it is a under root mean of the square of the instantaneous value. That's why it is called root mean. Root means this is root mean square. That's why it is called RMS value, because root mean square of the any instantaneous value. So I effective is what? Square of the root mean of the square of the instantaneous value. For example, as I already told you that if in your home there is a 230 voltage supply is there, this 230 voltage supply is basically RMS value, and if there is a 5 ampere or 15 ampere or 7 ampere, whatever the current is flowing in any particular circuit, that current is the RMS value of current. It is not average current, not a maximum current. So how you can calculate the RMS value of the current? Because as you know, the equation of this I is equal to Im sin theta t, this is a waveform of the current I is equal to Im sin theta t, just square of this one. So after the squaring, the waveform can be written as this one, because it is a symmetrical waveform. So just you have to analyze in the positive side only. Now it is a square one, so this one will be called I square. So what is the area? I square multiplied by d theta. Right, so area of this strip is equal to what? I square into d theta. So with help of the integration, you can again calculate the area of the first half cycle of the squared waveform. So this is the area I square at d theta, and you integrate from 0 to pi. So just put the value of this I is equal to what? Im sin theta t. Sin theta, just you square this one, so it is Im square sin square theta d theta. Im square can be taken outside from the integration. This sin square theta can be written as 2 sin square theta upon 2, means just multiplied by 2, divided by 2. And this 2 sin square theta is nothing but it is a 1 minus cos 2 theta, because cos 2 theta is equal to what? 1 minus 2 sin square theta, right? So now you have to integrate this one. So it can be written as, what is the integration of 1? Integration of 1, because you are integrating 1 with respect to d theta. So integration of 1 is what? Theta. This Im square by 2 is a constant. And integration of cos 2 theta can be equal to sin 2 theta upon divide by 2. Now you apply the limit, that is from 0 to 2 pi. So if you are putting limit in theta, it can be written as pi minus 0. This can be written as sin 2 pi minus sin 0. So value of this sin 360 is is what? Here you can see with the waveform also. At sine 2 pi is equal to 0, what is the value? It is 0. So sine 2 pi is 0, sine 0 is again 0, so it is 0 minus 0 is 0, it is pi. So after the solving, the area of first half cycle of the squared waveform can be written as pi im square upon 2. So what is the base from 0 to pi? So it is pi. Now you have to find out the effective RMS values. What is the RMS? Root mean square. So you have already calculated the area of the first half squared wave, and this one is a base. So area of first half squared wave is pi im square upon 2. Or just divide by the base, and what is the value of base? This is pi. So after the solving, it is coming im upon under root 2. So if you are solving this, it is coming 0.707 im. so IRMS value of current is equal to 0.707 times multiplied by the maximum current. So usually RMS value of AC is simply represented by capital I instead of IRMS. It is generally, I am saying, it is a 5 ampere current, so it is a RMS current. It is very understood. So next two terms we are going to discuss, that is a form factor, and then we will conclude this lecture. So form factor is what? The ratio of RMS value to average value of an alternating quantity is called form factor. So as you already calculated, what is the RMS value? It is 0.707 multiplied by Vmax, and average value is what? 0.637 into Vmax. So after the solving this quantity, you will get it is 1.11. So for a pure sinusoidal waveform, the form factor will always be equal to 1.11. So if you want to check whether it is a pure sinusoidal waveform or not, and if you calculate the form factor, if it is coming equal to 1.11, then you can say that it is a pure sinusoidal waveform. Next and last factor, that is a peak or crest factor. So crest factor is what? Crest factor is nothing but it is a ratio of peak value to the RMS value. So peak value is what? Peak value is basically you can say a maximum value, and RMS value can be written as 0.707 into Vmax. So Vmax is cancelled out from numerator and denominator, so it is 1.707, and after the solving it comes 1.414. So if it is a pure sinusoidal waveform, so crest factor, or you can say peak factor, will come 1.414. So in this lecture we have discussed very basic of the single phase AC circuit, like we have understood what is the RMS value, what is the maximum value, and the different terminologies are remaining. We will discuss in the next lecture, that means how to calculate this RMS value and average value for different type of wave shape. So in the you can say, if you want to calculate the average value and it is a symmetrical waveform, just you take the area of the positive half cycle and divide by the base, then you can calculate the average value. If you have any query, you can write the mail at sanjay.agrawal@igno.ac.in. And last, I would like to share that I am going to offer one course, that is a principle of electrical sciences through the MOOC platform. And in that particular course, I am going to discuss basic of electrical engineering, which is very useful course, and it is taught for the first year student for the all the branch, whether it is from civil engineering, electrical engineering or mechanical engineering. So if you are interested for that particular course, so you can enroll through the SWAM platform. That course is Principle of Electrical Sciences. Thank you so much.